Hey guys, it's Kay. Welcome back to my channel, The Organized Soprano, where we talk about all things domestic and dog. And today is another cleaning product range review. So in the past, we have done the laundress, and we have done a little bit of like talking about Mrs. Meyers, and we have done, what was the other one? The Good Home Company laundry detergent. So if you wanna watch those, I'm gonna link those in a playlist down below so you guys can hear all my opinions about these luxury, fabulous cleaning products. And today we're gonna talk about a company called Common Good. So Common Good is a variety of cleaning products designed to appeal to those who want to use natural items, even though if you've watched my channel, you know I have issues with the word natural, but they're basically designed to be non-toxic, gentle cleaning products so that you can use them around your pets, use them around your kids, and not really worry too much about having them being so close contact with harmful, more harsh ingredients, such as ingredients in like ammonia, chlorine bleach, things like that. I personally, in my house, do not use chlorine bleach because it is a lung irritant. I am a professional singer. I don't need that in my life. So I have found other ways to disinfect and sweep away bacteria. So this brand appealed to me, and I'm gonna tell you all about my experience with Common Good today. So first of all, about the brand, I'm gonna read a little bit from their website about the history of the brand and how old it is. They're a fairly new brand. I think they're only like 7 years old. So this is what they have to say on their website about the brand. Common Good was founded as a small initiative to reduce the amount of single-use plastic generated by household soaps and cleaners. As parents, we are not only concerned with the amount of recycling piling up, but we're also troubled by the ingredients found in those products. After searching the neighborhood in vain for safe, refillable household soaps and cleaners, we decided to launch Common Good in 2011. We developed green, biodegradable formulas that are Leaping Bunny certified and safe around kids and pets. We created a range of reusable plastic and glass bottles that can be refilled at our refill stations located nationwide. Our innovative, modern design offers an alternative to single-use plastics, making Common Good clean in every way. As someone who is trying to be better about my use of single-use plastics and make sure I put things in the recycling and properly recycle them, this appealed to me because if I can refill the bottles or I can purchase glass bottles and then take them to a refill station and not have to purchase a whole new plastic bottle, that appealed to me. So I went ahead and ordered from the Common Good website, and I'll tell you about that experience. So the Common Good website is really pretty. It's very clean lines, just like the product. Packaging, which is also very cool. We'll talk about that in a second. However, I placed an order directly from the website on August 21st of this year, and I received like an order confirmation, I think like shortly thereafter, and I waited. I waited to see if there was any update on the status of my order, and finally on the 7th of September, I inquired via email. This was a Friday, so I didn't hear back until the 10th, and I received an email from customer service telling me that due to unavoidable production delays, my items were not gonna be available for another 2 weeks. So at this point in telling me this, they also offered to give me an additional 20% discount and or a full refund. So I actually took the offer of their discount, their additional 20% discount, meaning I actually got 40% off the items. I think I had a coupon code to begin with. So I'm now purchasing the items for 40% off, which is great. I was a little disturbed that they did not tell me this, that I waited a while and then I had to inquire to get this information, but I was like, okay, I'm just gonna wait for it. So on October 10th, I remember this because I was at VidSummit, I inquired again to the same email address, and I'd like to inquire the status of my order. When I inquired, they told me that the bergamot dish soap that I had ordered was out of stock, and they didn't know when it was gonna come back in stock. So they offered to give me the lavender, which I was disappointed in because I had ordered the lavender bathroom cleaner, and I wanted to try a different scent so I could compare and see what they smelled like. But I was like so desperate to get the items at that point because I wanted to do this review for you. So I took the lavender dish soap instead. I did indicate in my email that I hoped that the products were good because the customer service was less than amazing because I had placed my order on August 21st and still was inquiring about it on October 10th. So that's a long time in the United States to wait for an order. Like, this is coming from the United States. So and nobody contacted me in advance to tell me that my order had been delayed or anything like that. I had to reach out to them. So there's something going on. I'm not sure what's going on. So later that month, around the 17th, I got a confirmation that my order was on its way, and around the 17th or 18th, I forget exactly what day it was, I received my order. In my order, I received the lavender bathroom cleaner, the lavender dish soap, which was supposed to be bergamot, a reusable glass spray bottle, and a reusable glass dish soap bottle. Everything came beautifully wrapped and beautifully packaged. So in my opinion, the products work great. They work great. They get the job done. They get things clean. The dish soap is nice. It doesn't froth up as much as like your regular commercial dish soaps are going to, but it's getting dishes clean. It's really nice. It was really nice to have this reusable glass bottle, which is really pretty. And you can see the sort of consistency of the dish soap is going to be, you can tell it's not as viscous, and it's a little bit different than like say your Dawn or your, you know, whatever dish soap brand you're used to using maybe. It's a little looser. I also really enjoyed this reusable bottle for, it's supposed to be all-purpose cleaner. It says all-purpose cleaning spray, but I actually put the Laundress all-purpose cleaning spray in here because I like the way that it smells. And I didn't buy any all-purpose cleaner from Common Good, so I wanted to try it anyway. I really like this bottle. It works really well. The sprayer is really great. I don't think this is anything super special. I think that if you purchase one like off Amazon, you could probably find one comparable quality, if not the same exact bottle. I know this is just a bottle with branding on it, so that's nothing special, but I do appreciate that they do sell them. So I use the bathroom cleaner to clean my bathroom. I will link the video up above in a card where you can see me actually cleaning the bathroom and using this item, and it worked amazing. It works great. The thing about these products that I really, really like is that the ingredients are exceptionally simple. This bathroom cleaner contains three ingredients, just three. It contains water, lactic acid, which is going to be your antimicrobial agent, and desyl glucoside, which is going to be a mild surfactant. For some reason, in the last maybe like 10 years, surfactants have gotten a bad rap. This is a mystery to me. Surfactants are soaps and are cleaning agents and things we use to clean things, your body as well. So I think there's a lot of like misconceptions about like, if are surfactants bad, are they good? Which I'll be doing a video about later, but surfactants in the way that they interact with your skin is probably of some concern for you, especially if you have dry skin. You wanna like maybe stay away from some of the harsher surfactants, but in cleaning items, surfactants are actually good. They're gonna take away, they're gonna grab dirt and oil. That's why they dry your skin out and dry your hair out, but they actually do grab dirt and oil and wash them away with water. So cleaning agents, surfactants are actually a good thing in cleansers, so I don't think they're necessarily going to hurt you. I don't know where that came from. Okay, rant over. Anyway, the ingredients for this are super simple, which I really appreciate. The same thing with any antimicrobial sort of ingredient or like antibacterial ingredient is that you want to spray it onto the surface and have it sit there for a little bit. You don't want to just spray and wipe away. That's not really going to kill germs. Having it sit there and just chill out for a few minutes, that dwell time, as Melissa Maker says on the Clean My Space channel, is what's really going to be antimicrobial for you. So go ahead, spray this on, let it sit a few minutes, and then go ahead and wipe it away. It works really well to clean the bathroom. Dish soap ingredients are equally as simple. It contains a few more. So the first one is going to be water, which is awesome. Again, the mild surfactant, desyl glucoside, that's just a mild surfactant, it's gonna help you get your dishes clean. The second one is another surfactant that comes from coconut oil. It's cocamidopropylamine oxide, that's just another surfactant, gonna help get your dishes clean. Then you've got phenoxyethanol, this is a preservative. This is an alternative to parabens. A lot of people are freaked out about using parabens. There's some studies, theories that parabens, which are also preservatives, may cause cancer. So a lot of people are looking for paraben alternatives. That's just one of them to help keep the product fresh. The next one is ethyl hexylglycerin. This is another paraben substitute as a preservative, gonna keep your product fresh. And lastly, essential oil. So it is whatever essential oil this is, you know, gonna be. This is gonna be lavender. There's also a bergamot. I don't know if there's another scent. Let me check the website. And unscented. Right now, they're offering two fragrances, bergamot, lavender, or nothing. Today at the refill station, and I'll tell you about that in a second, I picked up the glass cleaner in bergamot, so I was able to actually try the scent and see what it smelled like. Ingredients for this, also incredibly simple: water, desoglucoside, there's that surfactant again, lactic acid, that's gonna be like an antimicrobial agent, and it's also gonna be descaling, so if you've got some stuff on your glass, like gross stuff, this will get it off. Potassium hydroxide, which is basically a base, so it's gonna act as a buffer. It's gonna buffer some of that acid so it's not so acidy. And citric acid, which is essentially a fruit acid, like think like lemon juice, lime juice, grapefruit juice, that kind of stuff. I find that those things that are acids, like fruit acids, things like acetic acid that's in vinegar, is really great for cleaning glass and like really slick surfaces. It really gets all the like the nasty gunk off, and lemon. So that's why people are cleaning with lemon and vinegar all the time. So let's rewind to the refill station. So I went to a local natural store, which was listed on the website as being a refill station. So I had actually used all of my dish soap, and I hoped to refill it, see if I could see how much it cost me to refill it and see what the experience was like. However, when I got to the natural store, they told me that they have never been a refill station and that they are still listed on the website, and that they probably need to call them and ask to take them off, but they are not a refill station and never have been. And they said that they have actually had some trouble getting the items in as of late. When I went there, they had two items in stock. They had a bergamot linen water, which I'm not really sure what that is, and they had a bergamot glass cleaner, which I picked up for $7.99, which is fine. They marked it up $1 because on the website it's listed for $6.99, whatever. They have to make a profit off of it. But like, so they said they've had trouble reaching the distributor. I think that there's something going on with this company that they may be having real trouble getting their products out to people, which is really unfortunate because I think these products are actually really good. I feel like their company is in the middle of some change or something like that that I don't know about, that we're not privy to, so I'm not gonna write them off completely because of my customer service experience, but it did kind of put a bad taste in my mouth to begin with. However, I really do like the products. I think they're great. I think they're really simple. I think that if you are considering using some very safe products to use around babies, kids, pets, this is a great option. The price is a little bit up there, but it's not as much as Laundress. And I feel like it's comparable to some of the prices for like Mrs. Meyers and things like that, maybe a little bit higher. So I think this is definitely worth checking out if you can buy it locally, like if you can get it locally at a store, I would do that rather than ordering from the website, which I found to be somewhat unreliable. So those are my thoughts on Common Good. If you guys have tried these products, let me know in a comment down below what your experiences. If you guys like videos like this, is another one that you can watch right there. And if you're not subscribed, go ahead and subscribe for more cleaning, dogs, and organizing fun. And I will see you in the next video. Have a good one. Bye.